Clashing has always played a major role over the years. By highlighting and drawing attention to audiences far and wide to Birmingham's talented MCs and artists, parties, sets, pirate radio served as a battleground for MCs to lyrically compete for glory and dominance in the city. From classic bouts such as Power Hill versus NRG, which was broadcasted all over Passion FM, spanning all the way to the likes of Bomber B versus Jaykae, crossing paths at events like Goonies, platforms such as Lord of the Mics, Who's the Boss, and Prize Fighter was able to capitalize off this branch of the scene by facilitating clash culture to bridge the gap with other contenders from outside the city. For me personally, the biggest example of Birmingham's clash star power has always been Devilman versus Skepta.
This is how we do it right about now, yeah? Woo! Saying, yo, I'm like, no, I'm mad, try to come clash me, please don't bother. Put Skepta on the ground and dig out his eyes and make him bar for his mother. We don't like each other, only because I fucked his baby mother. We had that picture under the cover, she said the sex was like, no.
Yo, this clash done a lot for the scene, you know. It showed that Birmingham mans don't mess about, you get me? It showed that we were competitive in the music thing. And man can't mess about, bro. Man can't take man for a fool, you get me?
That one was just beyond iconic, innit? It was just like, I think with that particular clash, I think it's been talked about all over the world.
Your girl looks like Medusa, basically, that's why I didn't want to excuse her. But I still never had to excuse her. If you don't believe me, ask Bruiser.
And that was a big clash still. And at the time, that was where London grime was proper. It dominated it a lot. So for Devilman to come out and clash one of their main stars at that time.
And it's war, chop up guys with a score. I like to see blood and I need some more. I check to the brain to the bottom of the floor. I'm coming in, I'm trucking, I'm war. No guns in, no sweat, I'm coming with a chopper. When I see that, nobody going supper. If I'm a girl with a
yo, I said shame on. I've even definitely seen Drake, Nicki Minaj, these type of people mentioning that clash.
And I reckon he won at the time, personally. It's only because he was outnumbered. He's gone up there and he's won. Skepta's got the whole room. Do you get what I mean? But I think because he held his own against Skepta at that time, it made people look at Birmingham different. Like, yo, there's some MCs up there, you know.
Remember, you know, Skepta's a big name, innit? Them time there, still is. But it's like, bro, Devilman's clashing Skepta and it's big Lord of the Mics. Big, big Lord of the Mics. So it's like, that clash there, what Devilman done and just kind of how he shined the light.
That was a big battle, you know what I'm saying? And the fact that Devilman was just there, him and just a couple of man, you know what I'm saying, battling Skepta at the time when Skepta was like the biggest artist on the rise in London at the time.
Bro, like my said, it's a sound, it's a bro, sound man thing, blood. Yeah, so when you're spitting your bars, blood, you want forward, blood, you want, you get me? You want pull-ups, you want wheel-ups, you want reaction, exactly. Do you get me? So these Londoners are being biased, blood. Do you get me?
Very, that's why you need
spit
to
his bars, blood. There's no one reacting to his
but
stuff.
Man, you listen, but you listen, he's a man you listen
and
to.
Skepta's repeated a bar in the thing as well, blood. So by clash rules, blood, he lost anyway.
So for man to go there, yeah, and basically match up with them, man, and be outnumbered, being in their place and everything like that, and do what he done. And made a man after Allah spit his verse, same verse twice, and things like that. Like, that's commendable.
Obviously, Skepta must have slipped up still, where he repeated his bar, and he's even owned up to it himself, you know what I mean? So that could be one of the main factors what made me win that still, because you can't spit the same lyric twice in any clash, are you mad?
Skepta makes me laugh. I gave him an ounce of skunk and he thought it was a 4.5. About £50 for a gram. You get £40 for 0.8 to shoot up a blast.
See, in my perspective, that was mad, you know, because, like I mentioned earlier,
if Ra still peppered him,
bro,
I'm sorry, bro.
He's like, I don't know if they was testing us out, because not everyone used to mess with Brum, but obviously they got what they bargained for. That's a clash that's still talked about today.
Check, yo, jazz like this on you. Check, jazz like this on you, hey. Yo, fill up a vibe inside.
bro, the biggest standout clash for me that was instrumental, and I think like anybody that knows will say the same thing, is the NRG Power Hill clash.
Gunshot, gunshot, Diggy Deadly, were the only thing deadly is ya. Nee, that was my, to me, that was the funniest clash, Power Hill versus NRG. That's some old, old school clash. That clash was a moment. I remember everyone at school the next day going crazy over that.
That was like
100%.
Everybody. That was the first time that I actually sat in my house waiting for the radio to come on and waiting for the clash to happen.
I never really heard much clashing in Brum like that. So when you heard that on radio, that was a madness car. You're just thinking, yo, this is raw. Man are clashing, dissing family members and whatnot. You're just thinking, bro, what is this?
Like, that was the first time I actually wanted to wait. Like waiting up for a pay-per-view fight, bro.
Match,
yeah. For real.
It was like, serious.
It was mad.
So, yeah, clashing was just like... Clashing's always been a big thing. Obviously, clashing is Jamaican culture, isn't it? And Birmingham's a Jamaican stronghold. But I think in Brum, there's always been like legendary clashes. Like Deadly versus Genie is a legendary, absolute legendary clash from back in the day.
I think them man would like bump into each other and that.
And talk
like,
about
with
it.
NODB and Genie. So like, I think something happened in Mikey's flat with Hunter. And then obviously Genie was like, nah, fuck it then. We're clashing. I will snap your back. You can never come beat me.
Everyone from Birmingham who was involved in this scene then was locked in, listening to Silk FM, listening to Deadly and Genie clash.
The clash between me and Genie, legendary shit. Listen, before I say anything, big up Genie, yeah? Car, what man need to understand, Genie's a bad boy MC, bruv, yeah? And all now, throughout my whole career, I still think Genie gave me the best clash. That's what I'm saying.
It was like an unorganised thing in the dance. It just happened. And then obviously after that happened, that clash got organised on Silk.
Big Mikey set up a clash between NODB and Code Red, which was Genie's crew at the time. Obviously, we're all going back and forth on radio, but I don't know, like, for that moment, mine and Genie's clash just became a highlight because it was like, it was just kept going back and forth. He was gunning for me, I was gunning for him.
Genie and Deadly, yeah, that was a crazy clash because that was, don't forget, Deadly was probably 15 at the time. I can't remember how old Genie was, but he was old, you get me? And it was bar for bar, it was a sick clash, man. But I gotta say, I feel like Deadly edged it, you get me?
Me personally, I would say it's 1-1, but the crowd said I won. I would say mine and Genie's clash was 1-1. That's me being real, you know, like that. Old type Genie again.
Get fucked from the back, screaming la la la. I'm fucked 6 men on the camera. Don't give a fuck, my mum knows why you're telling her these everyday bitches are gas like a canister.
Jammer kind of orchestrated a clash, but he had Lord of the Mics. So I've come, and he's picked me against Nole because I was the first fiery female in the scene, apart from her. Because I was the next generation, and they put me against Nole. It kind of started from like some Twitter rubbish. She said something, I said something back. I'm young and reckless. She's a bit older with a bit more control. So I'm just being cheeky to her on Twitter. Next thing I know, Jammer's on Trickster's balcony. About Lord of the Mics, he's drove down here rapid and that. And then we're on Trickster's balcony. And when I look back now, my mum was just gassing it up still. Like, yeah, you know, you can take on Nole. You liar. I don't know why you told me to take on Nole. That was stupid.
Nikki gets fucked from the back singing la la la. I know a lot of men that wouldn't even dagger ya. Your big face looks fucked on the camera. Fuck all your followers. Twitter ain't paying ya.
Lyrically, she's sick. I'm not going to lie. Nole would duff up man lyrically. And it's that straight. There's not many men that can war Nole. Tell you straight. But it was healthy for the culture. I'm glad I did it. You know, Nole's followers went way up after that. I'm not saying I'd do anything for Nole, but it's all about the culture, innit? It's not about nothing else.
Should I really entertain the hype? Yeah, fuck that, let me claim the mic. I ain't never ever been a patient type, but you first, so I don't gotta say it twice. Look, you ain't getting paid, you ain't getting gigs. Why you talking hard? You ain't getting shit.
One female comes in and it will knock the next female out the game. That's how it goes with females, isn't it? There's only like one female spot at a time kind of thing.
What work? People see your baby mum, they're like, slag, it's work. I put more slags, spare ice in the middle of the porno mag.
I remember wanting to be on Lord of the Mics, the third one. Couldn't get on there. I was meant to clash Train Mission, unrolled. Like, this is how like deep it got. Like, they ended up getting me in. They was going to get me to clash Train Mission. It never ended up happening. I went to London and everything for it. It never ended up happening for whatever reason. But they said, yo, the next one. And then they offered me this guard out. And I was like, I swear down, honestly, I didn't know who he was. So I've gone, I've done my little research and that, and I've just seen like, yeah, he's just a hype MC, you get me? I thought, yeah, I'm gonna go in there and murk him.
Look at me when I'm talking to you. This clash, I'm gonna start walking you through. Round one dead, round two dead, round three dead, fam. I'm going on with your head. Somebody better start throwing in the fence. This ain't a clash, it's a murder case. I don't give a fuck if I'm in London. I'll throw him in the boot, then burn the chains.
I remember going to the clash, you get me? And my man's banging out bear props. He's pulling out bear props throughout the clash and whatever, you get me? And I know I'm on him and I'm spitting like, he's spitting 24 bars. I'm spitting 24 bars, but he's trying to cut me off after a 16. I remember a couple of times he tried doing it. And then he's complaining that I'm spitting too long. And I just thought, shut up, man. You're just chatting shit. And if you look on there, you'll see my knuckle duster there. Yeah, you'll see on the YouTube video, you'll see my knuckle duster in my pocket there, bro. I'm ready for whatever happens. Waiting. The depths of London, bro, we're deep in London. It's Eid day, I'll never forget it, bro. We're in London, it's Eid day. I've took about 20 men with me. We're on the one part of the stairs. The whole of London are upstairs. And they've got Safwan and Bomber all there watching the clash there. So they've brought Safwan and Bomber there, who I've already like had the previous with, you get me? So it's all like, it's fully against, man. Like, that's how they've tried to make it hostile against, man, you get me? And then, I had the t-shirt on, you get me, bro? And I just knew the whole way through, and I just thought, this is getting better because I'm winning and I ain't even pulled this out yet. And when I banged the t-shirt out, he lost his head.
And look over there, why cost you a bag, but yo, my t-shirt's priceless!
This is what isn't on the DVD. He started saying, oh, you set me up, Jammer. Jammer, you set me up. And Jammer's like, yo, are you mad? What are you on about? If anything, Jammer was favouring Discarder on that day. He was more Team London that day. I'll tell you straight, bro. Jammer's my boy and I'll tell you that straight. I wish they left that part in the DVD, you get me? He's my friend now, you get me? Discarder is like, he's a Lee, bro. He's a good guy, man. And I wish him the best, bro. Like, I said that was probably my most legendary clash, though.
Daniel, you ain't hard, like, come on, fam. You been here since I was on the come up, fam. You ain't get with young grind. Stick the baseline, that's fine. They want you, fuck off, fam.
Monday, I was in the studio, triples. I was with the man there. And I just got some tweet from Jammer talking about, yo. Yo, tracks versus, yo, what we saying? I'm baffled. I'm looking at this guy. Yo, I'm saying to the man, yo, blood. Jammer's talking about clash.
They call him Lil Capac because they toss and they get head from him.
What the Ross? Yo, what I'm dog at any shit and it's all basic, man. But I thought to myself, I might as well remix your stuff to show you how basic you are.
He was telling me I had to write bare 16s or something in like a short space amount of time. And I was like, you know, like, fuck it. Say if we go for it. I slapped myself in the studio. Bare rhythms, I just writing like a madman for this geezer. And then after that, by the time we got to the clash, I was just like, yeah, man, really?
Yo, it was a joke, of course it was a joke. Now check my skill. When I talk about girls, I talk about girls. When I give your girlfriend the eye drill, I'll bust in her eye, save you both money. Now no one needs to buy pills.
I would say me and Bomber was a legendary clash. Rest in peace, Bomber. Freaking hell. I would say that was a legendary clash.
He's going in now.
Me, 16.
Same.
I'm back, but I never went nowhere. Yes. I'm ahead of you by a long shot. Oh, yeah. Bully Bear Boys was hot for a whole year. The tune that is, because I'm the bully boy. The bully boy, I is. Man, I've had bar since I was a kid. So sniper on the rooftop, blip man down.
Me, you know?
Obviously, I'm around, like, Bomber. So the clashes that I remember are the ones that he partaked in. So him versus Daps, their little back and forth, that was epic. Me, you know, Daps is my brethren and Bomber's my cousin, so that was fun.
Because everything I'm talking about, Deadly, Genie, Power Hill, NRG, this is all before this. This is like 06, 07, 05 probably. You know what I mean? This is way before that. 09, I would say, was the resurrection of Birmingham Grime through Grime Blog, through me and Bomber, through Triller. I would say me and Bomber was one of the most legendary clashes because it started everything back.
I heard what Mima said, three letters, WTF. He reckons he's the best in grime. Me, I reckon I'm deaf or blind. He told me to check out my new tune and comment back what I think. I told him BRB, then I deleted the link and I have a
sports. Yeah, I felt like there might have been like, I felt like that was the first one, like energy. It was like people was actually asking if it was drama, if it was beef and stuff, you get me, phony man, and nah man, it's cool. Because there was just so much energy and vibes and everyone, I know Dats onto the pewter man, I'm the hardest, and Bama was on the same thing. But yeah man, so it was a good vibe, it was a good time, just fair energy, you get me?
R.I.P. Depps as well, because I remember Depps, before he passed away, was at a level where I don't think any other artist was.
And you're not that hard, I'm not gonna gas. Rude boy, you will get boxed in a clash. But I boy, Rude wants to get locked up so the penny can get fucked in his ass. Talking like saying you're hard and tough.
I remember H had already told me about it. He told me that Stormzy and Ed have reached out to him to jump on a tune.
Jet plane headed up to the sky. Oh, spread wings and clouds getting high.
I remember first hitting the scene, there was like another Brum rapper, the axe. You know how we get it, as Brummies.
We're on the rise, you know what I mean? It's not as hard as it used to be, where you had to move to London to make a name.
Yo, I said, head get boss up and split like Skilly Bang. Says, shot reach any city them there. G's in my unit from before, feedy them there. Man, I'm funny, I'm not feeding them friend. I'll be on smoke till me and me killy them dead. Bring badness, diddy them there. Man, want act like gal, we are tell them bullet we reach for your titty them there.
Now I'm here. No matter how hard I persevere, I've come so far. Now I'm here.
Destined for my destiny. Who really wants the best for me?
No matter how hard I persevere,
life always keeps testing me. Regardless, it won't get the best of me.
When things don't seem clear,
vision on blur, but I'ma keep giving them work.
I shall only face my fears.
No time to be scared, time to rise and time to declare. How can I take the high road when it feels like I'm walking on a tightrope? Looks like that's a 180, and I guess that's just how life goes. I used to walk through the door, now it's like a magnifying glass at spy hole. Regardless of the stitch, I cope, cause I got a good heart, and I know. Sometimes it hurts when your heart's good, and you're stuck in a stitch where you can't push. Life in mind, I could write me a hard book, but when I write the chapters, I can't look. And not many really care if Carl's good. Kill myself, they think Carl should, but the main thing is, I rather wouldn't. Break me down like rock wouldn't.
I've come so far. Now I'm here.
Destined for my destiny. Who really wants the best for me?
No matter how hard I persevere,
life always keeps testing me. Regardless, it won't get the best of me.
When things don't seem clear,
vision on blur, but I'ma keep.